New York! Guess what? I won the lottery! I'm taking y'all to lunch! My fortune! My freedom! Stay right there. Don't move.
Take that ticket and I'll buy you your own statue in the park.
That lady is gonna fall!
I'm not gonna fall. I refuse to fall.
Come here, you little feather ball.
I'll show you how it's really done.
The magic of movie making has more to do with illusion than reality. For instance, Bette's apartment was built in a soundstage here at our studios. All those street scenes weren't really filmed in New York City. They were done on our own backlot version of New York Street. When Bette climbs outside the window, it's really stunt double Carol Nielsen in a matching costume and wig. Back on the soundstage, we recreated the entire apartment. Watch out, Bette! This death-defying drop takes Bette to a foam mattress 2 feet down. Back outside, it's stuntwoman Carol hanging on for dear life. Don't worry, though. She's wearing a safety harness underneath her costume. Bette hangs in front of a blue screen so we can superimpose her over the New York City skyline. The banner fall is a series of shots using both Bette and Carol. Before this next complicated scene is filmed, director Gary Marshall makes sure that everyone knows the plan. And then it's time for one of the wildest rides ever down the sidewalks of New York. That shopping cart is controlled on a track, but some things just require the human touch.
Whoa! Perfect!
The subway stair sequence begins on the New York Street back lot and finishes inside on our sound stage. Remember the flight over the turnstile? That uses a compressed air catapult. Even though they fall apart, these aren't cheap shoes. The heels are just made of wax. And that fearsome subway train isn't what it appears to be either. But at least the crew makes sure it arrives on time. The final movie you saw today was just 2.5 minutes long, but it took a crew of nearly 100 people 5 days to shoot. That's the reality, but we believe the illusion was worth it.